Good morning. Hello, everybody.
Helen,
welcome.
Good morning.
Hey, hello, hello, guys. Jesse, new style. Jesse. Good. Very nice. Keirita, good morning. How
morning.
Are you? How are you? Ready? Helen,
yeah,
how are you? Did you miss the class, Helen? No, all right.
Yeah,
Helen, okay. ¿Ya pudiste activar ahí?
Sí, teacher, thank you.
Ok, perfect. Si no tenés el código o borraste la conversación, te la voy a volver a reenviar.
No, teacher, I'm ready.
Ya lo tenés. Ok, perfect. You're ready. Excellent. Ok. Erika, welcome. Ok, Jocelyn, hello, good morning.
Good morning, hey, teacher.
Good morning, teacher.
Hello, Victor. Hi, Erika. Hi, let me see. Milena, Dinorita, Vane, Roberto, Lilian. Okay, welcome, welcome.
Hi.
So early. Ready for tomorrow? For
good
your
morning.
Hora.
Yes.
Your second oral exam. Ay, Jocelyn. Don't get nervous, Jocelyn. Sí, sí, sí. Jesse is ready, right, Jesse?
Ya tengo lista la conversación.
Ah, you see. Jesse is ready. Yesterday he was a teacher. How do you say?
Yes.
Como decía, how do you say barra libre?
Noches intensas.
Okay. Tomorrow is going to be, okay, your class, okay? Why your class? Well, because you are going to present, okay? You are going to start talking about your likes, dislikes, using the expressions that we studied yesterday, okay? Today, we move on, okay, to this topic, okay? Look, this topic is here, okay? This is a healthy living, okay? Healthy living, okay? So there is a question here that says, are you doing anything to stay healthy? Okay, so... these are okay. This is the question that we are going to answer, okay, today. And I'm going to present here. Let's check here. Okay. Let me ask this question to everybody. Okay. Milena, for example, in your case, Milena, do you think you are a healthy person?
I try.
You try to be healthy.
Healthy, yes.
Ah, okay.
It's difficult.
a lot. I was checking this and everything is focused on hamburgers that they are so bad. And
pizza.
I love them. And I love them. Yeah, can you imagine? Dinorita, yeah. do you think you are a healthy person?
No, teacher. In my dream, maybe. I eat only junk food.
You eat only junk food. Okay.
Yes,
Fatima, what about you?
I try, teacher.
You try. What do
yes.
you do, Fati? What is the activity that you do to be a little bit healthier?
Okay. Sometimes I walk.
And
I tried don't eat oil.
Oil. Ah,
much oil.
Much oil. Okay.
Exactly.
Okay. Very good.
Yes. Fast food. Not much.
How often do you eat fast food, Fati?
One time.
A week?
15, no, 2 weeks.
Once every 2 weeks. Uh-huh,
yes,
every week. Uh-huh,
yes.
Every 2 weeks.
Uh-huh.
Oh, yes. Every 15 days, in other words. Uh-huh.
Exactly. Or two once? No.
No, two times?
Two times.
Or twice?
For 1 month.
Twice a month. Ah, okay.
Yes.
So every 15 days. Uh-huh.
Exactly.
Okay, very good. Let me ask the boys because sometimes the boys are like, what, teacher? What is healthy? Okay. Victor, what about you, Victor? Are you a healthy boy? Oh, do you consider you are a healthy boy? What do you think?
Good morning, teacher.
Hello, morning, Victor.
But I try to be a healthy people. Yeah. When I was a child, I'm vegetarian.
No, but... you are vegetarian.
No, when I was a child.
Ah, I was vegetarian.
I was, okay.
No, when you were a child, Victor?
Really? Yeah, when I was a teenager.
Really? You didn't eat, for example, meat, choripanes, yeah. Ham? Choripanes. I love choripanes. The
choripanes, really? I dislike it. Really?
And tell me, Victor, and tell me, what happened to you? Or are you vegetarian now in this time?
No, in this time, no. Because in 2018, I was sick and the doctor said to me that give me another diet.
Yeah. Oh, wow. You were sick. Yeah. You needed maybe proteins, meat and everything. Oh, yeah. So now, Victor, you are normal. Normal.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I'm sorry to use this this adjective. Okay, normal. No, but okay. I have a friend. She's vegan. I mean, she's not vegetarian. No, she's vegan. Do you know the difference, guys, between a vegetarian and a vegan? Who knows the difference?
Los vegetarianos creo que son los que pueden comer lácteos.
Yeah, the vegetarians can eat dairy products.
Dairy products.
Dairy products. For example, eggs, milk, butter, cream. But the vegans, guys, the vegans are they don't eat anything coming from animals, anything, no oil. They use special oils from plants. I don't know. I have a friend and she's vegan. So when she invites me to eat, it's difficult because everything she eats is very different from what I eat. Okay, that's it. My friends, this is what we are going to study today, okay? We are going to talk about how to be healthy or how to try to have a healthy life. And also, we're going to be reviewing the simple present, usually, sometimes, but we are going to mix, okay, two structures, the simple present and the present progressive, okay? We're going to go over this one, okay? Ay, what do you prefer, Katie? Be honest, be honest. Look at the picture, Keirita.
I prefer unhealthy.
Oh, really? The unhealthy food?
Yeah.
Okay, what about you, Gaby Sanchez? Tell us, what do you prefer?
In that case, I prefer healthy food.
Healthy? Ah, you prefer the fruits?
Yes.
Really? I like the fruits. Okay. Let's ask Roberto. Okay, Roberto, if you are, for example, I don't know, about 1 o'clock p.m. And then you have these two options, Roberto. One basket of fruits and a beautiful, delicious and juicy hamburger. So, Robert?
A hamburger.
Let's ask Vanessa. Vanessa. Vane. What about you, Vane?
I prefer, it's difficult.
No, Vane, come on. Is it difficult for you?
Yes, because my favorite fruit is the watermelon.
Okay. My favorite fruit is watermelon too.
And tomato, so it's difficult. But
tomatoes are your favorite vegetables.
Yes.
Really? Ah, okay. So you prefer the hamburger because of the tomato?
No. Yes, teacher. I prefer hamburger. Yeah.
Okay, okay, okay. So that's it. Very good. Very good. Let me. Well, Dinarita is
is my favorite food, hamburger.
Yes. And the hamburger is healthy, teacher, because yes, tomato, lettuce.
Yes,
it's true. Tomatoes. I agree with you. Hey, claps for you. I haven't thought about it. Ah, yes. Okay. Jose, what do you prefer, the fruit or the hamburger?
Hamburger.
The hamburger. Okay, it's healthy.
Hamburger.
Ah, the hamburger. Okay, very good. Let me see somebody who looks like very picky when you eat. Let me see. No, you guys, you look all of you. I thought, to be honest, Vane, to be honest, I thought you were always on this diet and blah blah blah. I don't know. Am I wrong? No, right, Vane, you eat whatever.
No, more or less, teacher.
No, whatever, teacher. Okay, but if I, for example, if I invite you to eat a piece of pizza, you eat it.
Yes, but I eat healthy 50-50.
Ah, okay.
In the weekend, when I go with my friends,
mm-hmm.
and I eat pizza, pizza, Hawaiian pizza.
Oh, I love Hawaiian pizza. But during the week, yeah, but during the week from Monday to Friday, you eat not just fast food, right? You eat healthy.
Yes, because when I could with olive oil.
Olive oil,
I include the vegetable. I don't eat a lot of meat.
Excellent.
And I try teacher.
Okay, very good, yes.
Natural juice.
Natural juice, okay.
I drink coffee, I drink green tea, I love green tea.
Ah, yes. Very good, excellent. I don't drink coffee either, but I drink a lot of other things.
Oatmeal?
Oatmeal, yes, okay, great. Yes. Okay, so look at this, right? Okay, fruits or hamburgers, right? Okay, what about this one? Jesse, what do you prefer, Jesse? A bunch of bananas or chips?
Bananas.
Really?
Yes.
Okay. What about you, Eduardo? A or B?
I prefer bananas.
Bananas too, and you don't like chips,
guys. I prefer the hairy wave.
Oh, okay. Well, when I represent these chips with papita lace, right? But you can include here churritos, taquitos, or
quesitos.
Tostecas, quesitos. Aha, okay, that's it. Helen, what do you prefer, A or B?
It's very easy. I prefer the lace.
The lace, okay, Jose. What about you, Jose? Jose is vegetarian.
I prefer letter A with
chocolate.
With chocolate. Let's make healthy food. Honey.
Honey. Yes,
honey. Oh, okay. Very good. Okay. You know what I do with the bananas, guys? I remember I told you I don't like bananas so much. But for example, I make milkshakes with banana. Okay, one banana or two bananas milkshake with milk. And I gave some to my daughter, my husband, and I add cinnamon. And I drink it. It is in some cubes of ice. It's delicious. That's the only way I can eat the bananas or Eskimo bananas, okay? Chips, very good. What about this? When my I just remember my mother says, Mommy, what do you have for lunch today? Ejotes con huevo. So, Jocelyn, what do you prefer? The green peas, okay, the green peas or the fried chicken? Be honest.
I prefer green peas.
Yo sí.
Yes.
Are you Salvadorian?
Está mintiendo, teacher.
Fried chicken is bad for me.
Okay. Yes. So you prefer the green peas. Okay, good.
Yes.
So you are conscious that maybe you are not healthy right now. You have a problem in your cholesterol, maybe. This is something that happened to me recently. I ate campero chicken like maybe 20 days ago, 15 days ago, more or less. And I promised myself, and I'm gonna be honest with you, I promised myself, and I said, Iris, please, next time you try to eat this, okay, try to zip your mouth, or I don't know. I asked God, please, que alguien me robe el pisto mejor. I don't know. I don't want. I ate this chicken, and believe me, my stomach was terrible. It's because of the excessive oil, right?
Me too, teacher.
Okay. That's the problem, Yossi.
Yes, yes.
Okay, very good. So that's why, guys, no, fried chicken, when I say fried chicken, I'm not referring to one specific brand. No, all the ones that you know that are popular in El Salvador. So it's difficult, but I love chicken, but I prepare chicken in my house, okay? For example, in onions, in tomato sauce, which is different, obviously. Okay.
Teacher.
Yes?
Do you like Pollo Bonanza?
Oh, I love Pollo Bonanza in El Centro, right?
Yes.
But I eat only once a year. You know why? Because my sister-in-law's present. And we know that she loves Pollo Bonanza, so we go and buy, but only once a year, no more. Mm-hmm. And how often do you eat Pollo Bonanza, Fati?
Maybe one, I don't remember.
Once a month?
Yes, once.
So you go downtown. Okay.
I love
you love it. Okay. Very good. Okay. What about this one? Okay. Let's see this one. What do you prefer, Estelita? Toki-toki? Toki-toki. or tang? We call tang, right? And this is natural. Mm-hmm.
To be honest with you, I prefer letter A.
Oh, letter A.
Natural juice.
What kind of juice do you usually drink? From what fruits?
Orange juice or lemon juice.
Lemonade.
Lemonade, yes.
Excellent. That's delicious. Okay, very good. And what about you, Irving? What do you prefer? Natural juice or artificial juice?
Natural juice. Juice.
Natural. Do you have a favorite that one?
Horchata.
Horchata. Oh, is horchata healthy? Horchata, Irby. But it's natural, Irby, right? I agree with you. I agree with you.
Yeah.
Okay. Yes. You know, nowadays, guys, is the time for mangoes, right? And my husband went to the market. My husband went to the market last Monday, and I gave him the list, right? And then, well, he got a bag, but a big bag of mangoes, green mangoes. So, and I say, hey, why do you have these green mangoes here? I didn't ask you to bring this or to buy this. And he said, no, they were $1, you know, a lot of green mangoes. And I made a juice, a mango juice. It's so delicious. It was
it's
so
delicious. Delicious.
Very delicious, guys. Very, very. Yeah. And also mangoneada. I made mangoneada.
Oh, yeah.
The best of the best mangoneadas, okay? 2 for 25, you get.
Okay. I love mangoneadas.
Yeah, me too. Okay, that's the best. Oh, this is difficult for me, huh? This option is difficult, okay?
For me.
For you too, Salita, what do you prefer?
Pizza.
Oh, really? I thought you were going to say salad, okay?
No, yeah. I love pizza. Pizza is my favorite food.
That's your favorite food, okay. Yeah. What about for Victor?
Pizza too.
Pizza too. Okay. Yeah. I think everybody likes pizza. Or is here someone who prefers the salad, guys?
Salad.
Me.
Are you? Oh, yeah. Katie.
Yeah.
Really, Katie. Why?
Yeah, I
don't like pizza.
I don't like pizza.
Oh, me too. Wow. You too?
Yes.
Why?
Don't like pizza.
You don't like pizza. No. Have you tried Hawaiian pizza? Oh, that's my delirium. Okay. Oh, okay. Very good, guys. If you don't like pizza, better eat salad, right? Okay. Hamburger or fried chicken or chicken?
Chicken.
Hamburger.
Chicken.
In this case, I prefer the hamburger.
Hamburger.
Wendy's is my favorite. I'm sorry, guys. I don't know if you like Wendy's, no?
Yeah.
Wendy's, yes?
Yeah.
Yes.
I went to McDonald's once, and no, McDonald's is only the picture, my friends. So expensive and very little.
Yeah. But. Uh-huh. In flavor, teacher, I prefer McDonald's.
Yeah, but it's very little.
Yeah, I know. But
almost $10, a little bit. Like a junior. Okay. Are you a Coca-Cola lover, guys?
Yes.
Yeah.
You accept your addiction?
Yes, no, teacher, I don't like.
Who said?
I don't like
Nora, Erika. You don't like Coca-Cola?
No, I don't like. I prefer water.
Isme?
Me too.
You too? You prefer water? Wow.
No, water.
Water. Listen, water. Eduardo, do you drink Coca-Cola? Cold.
No, I try to don't drink Coca-Cola because I had a problem in my stomach the last 5 years.
Oh,
so I can't drink Coca-Cola or milk.
You can't? Oh. Do you have gastritis or?
Yes.
Oh, back in time, when I was in high school, I always wanted to lose weight. I was not chubby, I was not chubby, but I was never thin, okay? Like maybe, for example, Wendy, okay, that I see that is, you know, thin. I was a little bit chubby, so I started to have a stupid diet, and I drank a celery juice, jugo de apio. Celery juice in the mornings. Oh, and I said, I'm gonna drink this juice and I'm not gonna eat my breakfast. So I'm going to start losing weight. Obviously, I lost weight. But I destroyed my stomach completely, guys. I remember one day I couldn't get up from my bed. My mother gave me pills or something. And when I drank water, my stomach was in pain. when I ate a little bit of cheese or maybe tortilla, my stomach was, oh, I went to the doctor, to the hospital, and the doctor told me, you're very stupid. And I said, what? Yeah, girls like you, they, if you want to lose weight, do exercise, but don't go on a diet. And I told him everything I did. They made a kind of a scan or something in my stomach, and they found out the beginnings, thank God, the beginnings of ulcer. Can you imagine? The pain was so hard. Yeah. And that day, I thought, yeah, I'm very stupid because I start to have diets or something. So if you want to lose weight, it's not to stop eating or consume lemon or whatever, because there are some people that say la dieta del limón, right? No, that burns your stomach and destroys your stomach and your system. Ooh, I was on a special diet like Eduardo. I remember the doctor told me no milk, nothing. Okay, no oils, no grease, nothing. Okay, just was like with requesón, special cookies, oof, very expensive food. But thank God I recovered from that illness. If you have this problem, okay, I always said so. I drank a lot of agua de papa. Agua de papa is the best for construct the flora again, okay? And I recover a lot from that. Thank God now I don't have gastritis, I don't have anything. But I am older than you now. I am 40 years old, so, but I try not to eat too much oil like Yossi, because then my stomach starts like, whoa. Like having a nightmare there, okay? Being healthy, guys. This is what we are going to have, okay, today in class. We are going to learn and practice some phrases, okay? Let's check the number one. And are you doing anything to stay healthy? Let's start with the first one. Isme, I want you to read the number one, please. Look at this boy. Maybe you have the same diet. I don't know. Go ahead, Isme. Well,
Well, I generally don't eat a lot of junk food, and I don't eat red meat at all. And right now, I'm doing karate. It's getting me in shape quick.
Quick, very good. Look at this expression. It's getting me in shape. Okay, this expression, in shape. This is like, hey, in Spanish, in Salvadorian Spanish. ¿Cómo le dicen? ¿Está bien?
Cuerito.
Cuero. Está cuero, right? Okay, no cuero que está muriendo, no. You are in shape or in a good shape. Okay, that's it. Okay, hey, you are
it's in a like a fit.
Like fit. That's it. You are in a good shape. Wow. Okay. Okay, then so for example, stand up, Gaby Sanchez. Wow, Gaby, you are in a good shape. Okay. Talking about Gaby Sanchez, where is the other Gavita? I haven't seen her for 3 days today. If you have Gaby Velasco's number, send her a message, please, to ask her. I thought she was going to appear today, but no, I don't see her here. Okay, that's it. This is the first one, Brian Jones. Okay, let's continue, Dinora, with the second one. Let's go with Carmen Sanchez, please, Dinorita.
Okay, right now, I am trying to lose way before my school reunion. So I am drinking this diet drink for dinner.
Carmen Sanchez, she's trying to lose weight, right? This is in English, perder peso, right? lose weight, lose weight. Before my school reunion, okay? Well, I have a wedding. I have a wedding in April and I have to lose weight because my dress doesn't fit. Okay, Carmen Sanchez. What about the other girl, Lisa da Silva? Okay, Josie, can you read it, please?
Yes. Not really. I cannot eat. I kind of eat everything I want. I don't do anything to stay in shape. I am just looking, I guess.
Ah, I'm just lucky, I guess. Lucky. Okay, very good. This is a friend of mine. A friend of mine eats a lot and she never gains weight. So I think she's lucky. Yeah, I eat one pupusa, the next day my cachetes are very, very, you see? There are people that eat a lot and they never, okay, gain weight. Okay, so she says, I think I'm just lucky because she doesn't do anything to be in shape, okay? The next one, okay, Roberto, please, mailing you.
I'm not doing anything right now. I'm studying for exams this month, so I am eating a lot of snacks, and I am teacher.
Oh, where are you, Robert? Here, mailing you.
Oh,
color blue, the Chinese girl. Uh-huh.
What? Well, I walk everywhere I go because I don't have a car, so I think I get enough exercise.
Ah, okay, very good. Look, she walks. Uh-huh. Very well, very well. She walks, the other person drinks a special beverages at night. Okay, very good. Let's see. Katie, read about Michael Evans, please.
To be honest, I am not doing anything right now. I am studying for exams this month, so I am eating a lot of snacks.
No, snacks, no, culebras, no, snacks.
Sorry. Yeah. I am not getting any exercise at all.
Oh, he doesn't do anything. Okay, he's eating. Maybe he eats a lot because he's stressed. Okay, that's it. Jesse, the parks. Read about these guys.
Okay. Yeah, we exercise 6 days a week.
This is Vanessa.
We go swimming every other day. And in
between,
we go to the gym. And once in a while, we go...
Hiking. Okay, once, Jesse.
Once, okay.
Once in a while. Ooh. Una vez al tiempo, ajá, we go hiking. Wow, okay, very good. ¿Ve? We exercise 6 days, okay, a week. We go swimming every other day. Un día sí, otro no, ¿ve? Every other day. And in between, we go to the gym. Wow, they have a lot of action, right? Okay, that's it. Very, very, very good. Okay, excellent. Now the question is for you. What do you do to be healthy? Okay, so I want you to think about it. Okay, and you are going to, okay, this is the question that you have to answer. Look, okay, are you doing anything to stay healthy? Are you doing anything to stay healthy? Well, you have to tell me, well, yes or no. Well, yes, teacher, okay. Are you doing to stay healthy? Well, this is my example. Well, nowadays, well, 20 days ago, I stopped eating normal bread. And nowadays, I eat just, what is it? El pan de, what is the other bread? El negrito, the color black. I forgot. Integral bread. I'm not eating other kind of bread, sweet bread, okay? I stopped eating that. I buy it in a bakery and I try not to drink soda or juice. I try to drink water in the morning, for lunch, at night, etc. So this is what I do. I don't do any exercise. I don't do any exercise, guys. The only exercise I do is to go up the stairs in my house when I go to my bedroom, when I go down. That's the only one, okay? What about you? What are you doing to be healthy? What are you doing to stay healthy, okay? This is what I want you to do. Jesse, you ask Milena, you listen to Milena's answer and you copy Milena's answer, please, okay? And then Milena, you ask Jesse and you copy Jesse's answer, okay? Copy the answer, please, in your notebooks, okay? And then we are gonna come back here. When you have the answer in your notebooks, take a picture, please, to the answer and send it to my WhatsApp, okay? That's it. Let's start working with your partners, please, in pairs. Some of you maybe are gonna work in trios because of the number of students, right? That's the question that we have there. What are you doing to stay healthy? What are you doing, okay, to be a healthy person? Okay, there we go, guys. Accept the invitation.
Doing, no copié la pregunta. Are you doing?
Are you doing anything to stay healthy?
Are you doing anything
to stay healthy?
Okay, so it's difficult to me. Yes.
Hello, Dino.
Hola. I am alone.
I am alone.
Me pregunté a mí misma y a mí misma me contesté.
I'm gonna send you right now. Hey, what happened to you?
Se unió Brenda, pero de repente se salió.
Brenda.
Sí.
No, Brenda has a lot of problems in here.
Yes.
Ajá. Okay, I'm gonna send you to another room. Okay.
Okay. Dice.
Go ahead.
I go out mm-hmm. to the walk.
To walk.
Walk, eso. Uh-huh. Ay, teacher. Uh-huh. Asusta, teacher.
Boo. I go out to walk.
Okay. Espérame, Gaby, que le estoy contestando aquí ya. Ya voy, permíteme.
Okay. I try drinking
water. And
for example, candies, artificial use, something else. Ah, and I didn't eat pasta. I don't like it. And let me see. And I didn't eat bread.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay.
Just that. Listen, teacher.
Yes. a cocktail of fruit. Fruit cocktail, I don't know. And in the night, I try to eat less than in the afternoon. For example, sometimes I only drink a cup of milk or a vaso, I don't know.
A glass
of milk.
Just that, ¿cómo se dice? Glass of milk, or
you eat other something else.
I add cereal like cornflakes.
Oh, at night, Isme.
Yes. that's all.
Mm-hmm, okay.
And you, Helen, what are you doing to be healthy?
Well, I used to do exercise, but currently no, I don't exercise anymore.
Oh, because why, Helen?
I don't have time for the university, the classes, English class.
Mm-hmm.
So for be a healthy person, maybe I don't drink Coca-Cola.
Ah, okay, ajá.
Any
soda or only Coca-Cola?
Any soda.
Ah, okay.
I prefer drink coffee or water.
Okay.
Did you go to a gym, to the gym, or did you do exercise in your house?
No, I do exercise in my house.
I did in the past.
Yeah. I did exercise in my house.
Oh.
Mm-hmm. Because the pandemic.
Oh, last year.
Yeah.
Yeah, the pandemic was difficult.
Yeah. Let's see. Other thing. That's all. I'm not really a healthy person.
Okay.
I was vegetarian.
You were like Victor.
Yes.
And what happened?
But 3 years ago or four, I don't remember.
Uh-huh.
It was difficult because, for example, in my house, my mom only cooked chicken.
Mm-hmm.
And something like that. And when I went out with my friends and to the restaurant, it was difficult too, because there weren't vegetarian food.
It was difficult
in the restaurant.
Mm-hmm.
It is expensive than eat junk food or normal food.
It's true, Isme. I try not to eat meat for sometimes, but it was so expensive to go to the supermarket and buy the food, the healthy food. It's true. Indeed. I agree with you. Mm-hmm. Very expensive. Okay, great. Okay, now you can copy in your notebooks Helen's answer, okay, and send the picture to my WhatsApp, okay? And Helen, you do the same.
Okay.
Tengo el perfil para lo contrario.
For a singer, a famous person. Hey, what do you do, guys, to be healthier? Tell me.
Robert tries to walk every day.
Oh, really, Robert?
Oh, yeah.
Hey, how much time do you run? Do you walk?
30 minutes.
Wow, that's okay. Uh-huh, very good.
But what?
Where do you walk?
In my city, when I go out to visit some friends, or when I go out to buy something in the market.
Okay, you go by on foot.
Can you repeat it again?
When you visit your friends or you go to the market, you go on foot.
Okay. I like it.
Great, very good. And what about Irving?
Teacher, how do you say kilometers?
Kilometers.
Kilometers. Kilometers.
Kilometers.
3 kilometers.
Really? Wow.
Hmm.
Tell me.
I spend sitting all day.
No way.
I'm fat. Yeah, what?
What about guys in the pandemic? You didn't I don't know, you didn't do any exercise when you were...
I did a lot of exercise.
Ah, really?
Yeah. With my mother.
Wow, I didn't do anything, my friend. No, I didn't do anything. Before the pandemic, guys, I was not very thin, but I was thinner than I am now. Most of my clothes that I used to wear when I worked, and I went to the place where I worked, it doesn't fit anymore. Yeah, now I am a little bit like worried. Yeah, because now I have to do exercise a lot. Okay.
But in my case, wasn't by to be healthy.
Mm-hmm.
It was to avoid the anxious.
Oh.
To stay inside my house all the time.
Okay. You were anxious.
Anxious. What is anxious?
Anxious. Ansioso. Anxious.
Ansioso.
A lot of anxious. Oh, I see. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think the same. Most of the people were anxious, and the only thing we had to do is to eat, cook, right?
Yeah.
Play video games. I don't know. Do something like that. Yeah. Or watch TV. Yeah. Cook, eat. Watch TV. But we have to thank God, because we were in a pandemic, and thank God we had food. Food to eat. There were some people that really had bad times. Okay. That's it. Great, guys. Copy your answers, please, in your notebooks. Take a picture and send it to me. Okay.
Okay.
Thank you.
Doing a video. I eat less bread. I try to exercise twice a week.
Twice
a week.
Okay, thank you guys. I am receiving your okay. Very good. Send me the pictures. Continue writing your answers. I'm waiting for your answers here. Okay, and send me the pictures. Okay, to my WhatsApp. Okay, great. Let me check here. A lot of people here are healthy. Congratulations. You walk, you do something, huh? The only person is Dinora. The answer is never.
I tried, teacher, I tried.
No, now, Dinorita, well, that you are pregnant, you have to walk.
Yes, yeah. Por eso es que I try. In this moment.
Yeah, my friend.
No se bien,
yeah. Have you thought about the name of the baby? No, you don't know if it is a boy or a girl, right? What's your baby's name, your daughter?
It's Valeria.
Valeria, okay. If it is a boy, Valerio. No. All right.
I like Andrew.
Andrew, okay. Yes. Very good. And yes. One of your husband's name?
My husband's name is Manuel.
Manuel.
But Manuel, yes.
No. Choose one name of an ex. That would be good.
Dinora is pregnant. Teacher.
Yeah, Estelita, yes. You didn't know that.
Thank you.
Yes, in the pandemic. And what's not in pandemic?
No. It's not in pandemic.
No.
What's it's not in pandemic?
Es lo malo que trabaja en casa, no mentira.
Yes, we're gonna have but we don't know how to celebrate a baby shower online. Well,
okay, no problem.
We can celebrate on Zoom.
A baby shower online, Jesse is gonna give you even a house, right? Online.
No, we can send presents to the Nora teacher.
Yes, of course. It's true.
Yes, we can make baby shower.
This is true, absolutely true, right? But first, we're going to know if we are together when it is about to deliver the baby, right? Okay, great. Thank you, guys. I am receiving your Milena, Wendy. Okay, Milena, Wendy, Eduardo, Helen, Irving, Gabriel, Tobix, Lenita, Erika. Okay. Okay, very good, Nancy. Okay, very well. We're going to start, okay, but now then I'm gonna read the answers, all the answers that you have given me, okay? Now, my friends, this is what we are going to try to fix, okay? Because still there are some things here. The simple present and present continuous, okay? The simple present, I remember one of the one of the questions for the last oral exam was, hey, and what do you do in your free time? Or what are your hobbies? Y muchos de ustedes, digo muchos porque sí habían varios, me respondían así. Oh, in my free time, I watching TV, I cooking for my family, I... Y le ponían ese verbo con ING. I listening, and that's it. Se los digo en español para que quede clarito. Cuando usted le pidan la pregunta que qué haces en tu tiempo libre, tus hobbies o actividades, ¿ok? Que no estén pasando en el momento, usted siempre tiene que usar el presente simple. O sea, rutinas, ¿right? Pero, ¿qué es eso de simple present, teacher? Simple present es cuando pone el pronombre y el verbo sin nada. No me le ponga ING, no me le ponga, tampoco el verbo en pasado, no. Le pregunté a alguien, what do you do in your free time? What do you do in a typical Saturday? En un sábado típico, right? In a routine on Saturday. Y me dijo los verbos en pasado. I went to the, I go to the, ¿qué más me dijo? I watched, etc. No. In a typical routine, ¿ve? Tiene que escuchar bien el oídito. What do you do on weekends? Ah, es una rutina, right? No le estoy preguntando what do you do last weekend. No, it's in the present. So miren, lo único que tiene que ser es I walk, I watch TV, I listen to music, I read a book, I clean my house, I practice a sport, I go to the gym, I swim, look. No estoy usando ING. I swimming, I cooking, I drinking coffee with my... No, my friends, ¿ok? So, mañana que vaya a hablar de sus likes and dislikes, cuidado con esto. Teacher, pero usted dijo que después de las preposiciones y después de like, love... Sí, pero si se fijan, el verbo like, love, hate, va en su forma normal. Ya después de ese verbo, sí, ya le agrega lo que vimos ayer, ¿ok? So, this is the simple present to talk about all the time and routines. Cosas que haces usualmente o cosas que haces generalmente, you have to use simple present.
Teacher.
Always. Yes, tell me.
Cuando son terceras personas, no, siempre le tenemos que poner la S al final.
Siempre. Ajá, this is a must. Ahora, cuando te preguntan por you, ok, tú dices I, el verbo normal. ¿Qué pasa si yo te pregunto de Isme? Your sister, your mother. Ah, como es mujer, le agrego la S. Wendy walks every day.
Ah, ok.
Wendy drinks a lot of water. Wendy usually goes to the supermarket. Gabriel, ¿ve? Usually or generally plays soccer. Pero ese, no ING.
Okay.
That's it. Esto es cuando usted vaya a hablar de cosas que hace usualmente, generalmente, a menudo y de rutinas. Always, always, always. ¿Ok? Ahora, ¿qué frases voy a usar con simple present? Do you remember? ¿Cree que me ayudan, please? Tell me. Con simple present. Simple present. Hay ciertas frases que deben de usar cuando usan simple present. ¿Ok? Aquí les pongo cuál es the present simple present. The subject, my friends. The subject plus verb plus complement. Look. No les estoy poniendo ing ni nada, right? Okay, so what are the time expressions? The time expressions for the simple present. Help me, please.
Usually.
Usually. Always.
Nowadays.
Nowadays. Very good. It is important. Okay. Nowadays, que es ahora en día, right? Actualmente, remember. Other.
Frequently.
Frequently or often, right? A menudo, cuando usan never, right? Cuando me dicen, teacher, yo nunca cocino, no, fíjense, ve, I never cooking. Okay, I never cook. So this is what you have to remember. Okay, le hice la pregunta a alguien más y le pregunto yo. What do you do? What do you do? This is the question, guys, for the remember occupation. Do you remember? Y yes. Me respondieron así, mire. I study English. English. Right now. ¿Cuál creen que es el error ahí?
Right now, porque de presente continuo.
Excellent, very good, Jesse.
Right now.
This is the problem. ¿Ve? Mezclamos expresiones de tiempo que no van con simple present y las ponemos esa mix. Ese mix quiero que cambien hoy. Cuando diga, now, teacher, now I eat. ¿Ve? I eat chicken. Ahora, remember, now, right now, in this moment, present continuous, porque la actividad está pasando ahorita. Pero si usted dice, quiere decir, aquí cuál es lo correcto decir. What do you do? Oh, I study English. I study English. I usually study English, right? Pero si estudia inglés, entonces solo diga, I study English. Ok. So,
se da a entender que es de rutina.
Very good. ¿Ve? ¿Ve? Le pone esta, mire. Nowadays, I study English. Right? So estoy diciendo, actualmente yo estudio inglés. Because nowadays is for simple present and the sentence is in simple present. Ahora, si la persona me hubiera dicho, teacher, pero es que yo quería decir right now, right now. Entonces, ¿cómo hubiera sido la estructura? Tell me.
I am.
I am.
Studying English.
Studying. ¿Ve?
Studying
English right now. Hoy sí, ¿ve? Porque el right now, guys. Ok, el right now lleva esta característica, verbo to be, ing, verb be, ing, verb be, ing. Don't forget that. No solo es ponerle ing, porque hacíamos la broma, ¿se acuerdan? De Indian. Yo estudiando inglés, how, how. Ok, do you remember? Ok. Teacher, I cooking, yo cocinando piel, okay? No, so you have to say, I am cooking. Más humano, ¿eh? Yo estoy cocinando. Pero cuando me le pregunten de daily routines, nunca me use el presente continuo. No, daily routines, guys, the verb in the original form, okay? Daily routines. For example, this is an example. My friend Irving. Hi, Irving.
Hi, teacher.
Hello, Irving. Excuse me. What do you do in your free time?
I play video games.
Can you repeat, please? What do you do in your free time?
I play video games.
¿Será mi oído? El que está lleno de... Okay. Yo escucho que él me dice esto, ¿ve? Así, Irving. Así, Irving.
Yes, sir.
Okay. ¿Qué dice el público? Ajá, what do you think?
No, teacher. Creo que no se tiene que usar el am. Tiene que ser I
play video.
Ahí está. Muy bien. Irving, cuidado. Esto ya no, esto fue lo que yo les dije en el módulo 1, que no lo vayan a hacer por nada del mundo. ¿Ok? Mire, porque aquí Irvingcito está diciendo, yo estoy jugar. Y yo quiero que digas, como es rutina diaria, tu tiempo libre es una rutina, right? Usted solo tiene que hacer esto. Mire, I play video games. ¿Ve? I play video games. Only that. Y así van a seguir con los demás. Vamos, Irving, once again. What do you do in your free time, Irving?
Okay, I play video games.
Ajá, what else?
I swim in a tecosol.
Okay, very good. Excellent. Yeah. Continue.
And then I play the guitar. Yeah.
Great. Very good.
Yeah.
How much time do you practice?
Every day, more or less, 15 minutes.
15 minutes? Okay, yeah. Excellent. Very well. Okay, you see? What do you do in your free time? Okay. Next, Erika. Listen, Erika, can you please tell me your daily routine, Erika?
Yes, teacher. Mm-hmm. Okay. I get up in the morning in 8 o'clock. At 8 o'clock.
At 8 o'clock,
and,
uh-huh.
Okay, and I eat my breakfast.
Okay.
Uh-huh. I study English the 8 o'clock and then 10.
Uy. Esa corrección creo que se la hice en el examen oral. De para. From 8 to 10.
From 8 to 10.
To 10 a.m.
10.
Okay, very good.
Okay, from 8 to 10 a.m.
Uh-huh.
And I eat my... I cook my lunch.
Lunch, uh-huh. Uh-huh.
And I don't know, I go the father's house.
Ah, very good. And excuse me, what do you do on Sundays in the afternoon?
Sundays, mm-hmm. In the afternoon, okay. I don't know, I play with my father and my sister.
Mm-hmm.
And I eat pupusas.
Oh,
with my father,
delicious.
My
Where do you go?
I go in father's house.
Where do you go?
I go in at the father's house.
Ahí está, oiga, es rutina, entonces no tenés que decir going.
Oh, okay, I go.
Siga con el verbo normal, remember, okay? That's it. Vamos, otra vez, Erika. Where do you go?
I go in father's house.
¿Tú?
My father.
I go to?
I go to the father's house.
Ah, to my father's house. Great, very good. Yes. How many pupusas do you eat?
I eat 3 pupusas.
Ah, very good.
$1, yes.
Okay, great. Aplausos, okay. Very well, very well, very well. Eso también quiero que tengan cuidado. Al principio comienzan bien chivo, ¿verdad? I clean, I go. Y al final se le va descontrolando otra vez y cae. Como este es un error que quizás está metido en la cabeza, es difícil... A la primera quizás corregir todo, ¿ok? Pero this is, guys, what you have to know. the routines, the activities that you do generally or usually, often, always, you have to use the verb with no ing, please, no. When are you going to use present continuous? Ahora vamos a ver el otro. Y sí, miren, right? Oh, the present continuous, it says something like this. Look, this is to talk about now, these days, this month, temporary events. Okay? Es para hablar de lo que está pasando ahorita o lo que está pasando en este, como eventos temporales. For example, ¿qué podría ser un evento temporal? What do you think it's a temporary event?
Cuando va uno a la escuela, quizás. Porque no va, no sé.
Ok. Temporary event sería cuando vas a la escuela, fíjate, Toby, es como que no vas un mes ni dos meses, vas ya un año, dos años, y eso ya se hace rutina, ¿ok? Aquí vamos a usar, en temporary events, guys, vamos a usar estos días, este mes, ¿ve? Por ejemplo, no sé si tal vez este ejemplo queda cuando dicen, fíjese que ahorita estoy tomando un curso de cocina y es un mes. Oh, in this month I am taking cooking classes. Okay, I am taking cooking classes. For example, en el caso de mi amiga ahí, Gaby en Estelita, cuando me dijo, teacher, these days I am taking a training at Sykes or a TP, etc. Okay? So, it's temporary event. No quiere decir que no va a pasar todo por muchos años en esto, right? Ahora, la clase de inglés que está usted ahorita, ¿cómo lo considera? ¿Como un daily routine or temporary event? What do you think?
Daily routine.
Well, it could be considered like a daily routine, okay? Ahora, si le preguntan en una entrevista, do you study? Oh, yes, I do. Oh, where do you study? ¿Ve? I am studying at English Speak Academy, okay, this month, right? Ahora, ¿por qué no se puede decir aquí como I study at, like, porque aquí es, si usted no cuida esto, la pierde, right? And that is a temporary event for you then, okay? So, it depends here, okay? Both are acceptable, okay? Another one, que comencé a ir al gimnasio. Ah, okay, pero ¿es una daily routine or temporary event? What do you think?
Temporary event.
Temporary. Si acabo de comenzar, es temporary. ¿Ve? Okay. And what are you doing? What are you doing these days? ¿Y qué estás haciendo estos días? ¿Qué tal? ¿Cómo estás? Oh, you know, I am going to the gym this week. ¿Eh? Le agrega eso. This week, now, right now, in this moment, at the moment. Aunque esa es específicamente in this moment, at the moment, es lo que está pasando ahorita. For example, right now, I can say, for example, Nancy is, Yesenia is talking, ¿eh? Right now. Okay, Gabriela is talking with her grandmother in this moment. Porque está pasando en este momento. It's right now. Look at Dinora. Dinora is thinking about... Vanessa is laughing right now. It's right now. In this moment. At the moment, es específico para lo que está viviendo en este momentito, right? pero these days, this month, this week, now, those are for temporary events, okay? That's it. Yo trabajo en las de 8, fíjense que yo antes no trabajaba durante el día, yo trabajaba solo de noche dando clases, right? Teaching classes. So, pensé yo que iba a ser temporary event, teaching classes in the morning, pero no, I like to teach in the morning better than night. So, in this case, it is not a temporary event anymore. For me now, it's my routine, okay? So, this is what you have to think about. What sports are you playing these days? Oh, I am doing karate. It's getting me in shape. ¿Ve? This is the clue. These days. Okay? Si yo alguna vez les pregunto, hey, Vane, what are you doing these days? No me va a decir, oh, I cook, I clean. No, that's your routine. Algo que estás haciendo estos días. Algo nuevo, right? Oh, you know, I am studying English. Oh, really? Yes. And I'm taking an online classes of mathematics, for example. Porque eso es lo nuevo, okay? The new routine in your life, okay? So, be careful, guys, with this, please, with the present continuous and the simple present, okay? No se les vaya a olvidar. Mañana is your evaluation. So, mañana tienen que estar usando prácticamente esto, right? Pero si usted quiere decir, I like, pues después, I like to, I like going, that's okay. I love to, o I love doing, I don't know, it's okay. Pero ya el verbo love and like van simple, okay? That's it. So, ¿qué es la clave aquí? The time expressions, my friend. The time expressions, okay? So, let's hear here, okay? This, I don't know, Jesse, if you can do this, the screenshot. Okay, Jesse, can you please help me? Because here is a mix, my friends. This is a mix. We have these three conversations, conversation 1, 2, and 3. And you have to use, listen, you have to use simple present or present continuous. Oye, ¿cómo lo voy a, cómo que lo voy a descifrar? Well, look at the time expressions. The time expression is mandatory here. Okay? That's it. Did you take the picture, Jesse? Yes. Okay. Now you can check right now your, okay, you can check your WhatsApp, okay, my friends, that's it. Then you have the exercises. Do the exercises over there, okay, do the exercises over there. I'm gonna give you some time to do, complete the conversation, finish the conversations, complete the conversations, and then practice the conversations. I'm going to ask you when we come back for the correct answers. Okay, there we go right now. Let me check here. You're gonna work right now in pairs. Go.
Pantalla.
Sí. Por favor. Todo la oración. Pues.
Ok. Ahorita entonces.
Vaya.
Ahorita. Clamando.
Voy a intentar a ver si puedo. Porque no sé, no se me actualiza esta cosa.
In Spanish, we can say, ¿cómo lirías con el estrepo? Okay. How do you cope with the stress?
Qué mujerón.
Sí. Sería aquí, como es pregunta, ¿are you get stress?
Why are?
I don't know, because it's a question.
No, do you? Uh-huh. Do you? Porque si arriba este está preguntando con el do. Sigamos con el do.
Ah, sorry.
Do you?
Remember, Dinorita, that you never use are with other verb.
Okay.
Okay. Never.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Oh, yes, teacher. Oh, sorry. Ya me acordé que lo acabo de decir.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Desde el módulo 1.
Yes.
Teacher,
es así, le quitamos la boca a todos. No sé qué hacer para lidiar con el estrés que me dan.
Yeah.
Sorry, teacher.
No worries.
Do you care this person a lot?
I am. Bueno, y dale yo con el ánimo. No sé.
Well, generally, I am not.
Generally. That is your time expression.
Okay. Generalmente.
Sí.
Simple past.
Ajá, claro.
Okay. Entonces sería I don't feel.
Ajá.
I don't feel.
Okay.
I don't feel.
Me hablabas, tú me hablaste primero.
Stressed. But we
work.
Allí está en el grupo.
Sí, pero lo ando buscando en el en que me caiga en Word, o sea, buscar la imagen Word y ponerlo ahí. Eso no sé, fíjate.
Teacher, we sent this exercise.
No, this one no.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, you can write
the answers in your notebooks, right? Because then we're gonna check the answers together.
Lo comparto la pantalla.
Mm-hmm. Sí, solo compartirlo.
Ya lo he escrito.
Ajá. Sí,
pero,
está bien.
Pero a lo mejor voy a poner la otra. Yo voy a poner la otra mejor, pero que se ve bien feo esto. Vaya, aquí sí se ve.
Vaya,
dice conversation with the present or present continuous. Then practice with a partner.
Do you get stressed a lot?
Well, January.
¿Cómo? ¿Cómo me dijiste?
Sería.
¿Cómo me dijiste?
Creo. Do you get in present simple? Simple uh-huh. present.
Uh-huh. Pero uh-huh. sí.
Yes, do you Sarah. Get?
Do you? Porque están voy a hacer. Are you? Uh-huh. I get stressed a lot. Porque ahí está el verbo. Porque si uh-huh. le pones do you, acuérdate que el do uh-huh. es para el do es el auxiliar.
Ajá. Uh-huh.
Aló.
For sí. me,
are you
for are me, you for me, getting I are you getting
stressed. Ajá, you getting stressed a lot. No sé. ¿Tú? ¿Qué piensas?
Sí, quizá. Maybe. Sí, no. Yes. Entonces, las, no, la no otra sería... Well, generally, I am not feel...
Pay attention to the time expressions. Esta es la clave aquí de time expressions. No los ignoren. Por ejemplo, la primera le preguntan, ¿y cómo lidias con el estrés? Le dice, how do you cope with the stress? Acuérdense que son preguntas de usuales que ustedes hacen, ¿ok? Y se preguntan, ¿verdad? Entonces, la segunda, la, mire, sigue la segunda, no es la conversación B, es la conversación A siempre, ¿ok? Ustedes dijeron, are you getting stressed a lot?
Well,
¿te estás estresando mucho o te estresas mucho? What do you think?
¿Te estresas mucho?
Ajá, very good. Entonces no le tengo que you... poner are you. What is the question?
Vamos de compras.
Do you?
Do you? Ajá.
Do you get
stressed a lot? Ajá. Now look at the answer. Well, generally, this is the time expression. So, when generally, usually, always, sometimes, what do you use? Simple present or present continuous?
Simple present.
Ah, okay. So, you have to answer with simple present. What is the simple present for not feel?
I don't feel.
Exactly. Okay.
Okay.
Thank you.
Va. Y miren allá más adelantito está la coma y después dice but we in paréntesis work long hours this month the time expression changed so now you have a different sí. time expression okay so go thank ahead you. Uh-huh.
Okay.
Not really. Not really, but my wife and I enjoy.
Ajá, porque enjoy es disfrutar. Sería como...
Sí, vamos a ver el par de Indians aquí.
What?
Yeah, look, miren las present continuous. We working long hours. I taking a meditation class right now. How? ¿Qué le falta? ¿Qué le falta eso? Eso no es presente continuo. Ahorita solo me le han puesto el ing al verbo taking y relaxing. Working. ¿Qué le hace falta para que realmente suene normal? Porque ahí suena lo indio. Indígena, sí, de aquellos piel roja, right? Ajá. ¿Qué le falta, Fati? Y ahí dice, pero nosotros trabajando. ¿Cuál es?
We are working.
Ay, exactly. Les acabo de decir eso. En present continuous... Nunca olviden el verb to be. Okay. Si no, le dice la broma. Suena como indio. Y me lo están poniendo sin eso, entonces suena como indio. Arréglemelo ahí, por favor.
Okay.
Dice, dice ahí, but generally I don't feel stressed.
But we are working.
Excellent.
Long hours this month. Okay.
Very good. Bye. Excellent.
Oh. Mm-hmm. And yes, are.
Yes, are working.
Are working. Remember. En inglés, el verbo con ing no solo se pone por ponerlo. Mm-hmm. Tiene que saberlo conjugar ahí con el verbo to be. Exacto. Bye. Me arreglo okay. Los demás. Ok. Allá voy a regresar. I want to come back in a minute. Okay. Helen, hello. Your microphone, Helen.
Sorry.
What's your partner?
No tengo. Desde el inicio.
Se conectó Brenda. Okay. Mm-hmm. Se me fue entonces Brenda. I'm going to send you to another one.
Okay.
Okay.
Thank
vamos.
You.
Let's see this one. Okay. Let me check. I'll see the invitation, please.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Entonces, ahí abajo sería we,
oh, base for.
We usually go to the pool together in the summer. Ajá, no puede cambiar el verbo.
Tiene que ir en...
En presente. En normalito. Como dice la teacher, chulo.
Ay, Margarita. Ay, Margarita. Can I read? Vamos arriba. Quiero leer cómo van. Okay, go ahead.
Okay.
Let me check. How do you cope with the stress? This is like, ¿cómo es que lidias con el estrés, Liz? Okay. Mm-hmm. Are you... lo primero.
Entonces ahí sería...
Nunca me mezcle el verbo to be con otro verbo que vaya sí. Sin ing. Please. Ajá, very good. Do you get stressed a lot? Generally is a time expression, right?
Mm-hmm.
For simple present or simple or present continuous.
Simple present.
Entonces, uh-huh. Si es simple present, ¿qué está haciendo ese verbo to be ahí?
Oh.
¿Cuál es el auxiliar para negar en
I
presente?
I don't feel.
Excellent. Bye. I don't feel stressed. Uh-huh. But we, ve, par de piel rojas, pero nosotros trabajando. But
we work.
Nah, uh-huh. Porque mire la time expression, busquen la time expression. Mire cómo dice después de work, long hours this month.
Month.
This month. So this is simple present or present continuous?
This month
es simple continuous porque es momentáneo.
Sí, porque está diciendo simple continuous, me estás mezclando los dos nombres.
Present
continuous.
Present,
okay. Present continuous, pero para que sea presente continuo, les dije, no solo me agreguen ing porque suenan a indios, les dije yo.
Ajá.
¿Qué tienen que agregarle?
Yes.
Bye. We are. Wow. Y el otro. Wow. We are working. Ajá. Much better. Uh-huh.
Uh-huh.
Tienen que poner atención a la time expression. Ok. Porque uh-huh. Cada oración tiene su time expression diferente.
Uh-huh.
Y dice, but we are working long hours this month. Mire, ya ven un punto, quiere decir que esa oración terminó y empieza una nueva. Uh-huh. So, my coworkers and I, y después dice ta 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 ta, take en paréntesis a meditation class right now. So right now is the time expression. Ok, ahí está muy bien, solamente que el verbo to be está malo porque dice my co-workers and I. No solo porque lleve el I va a ser am.
I am.
No, tienen que ver si está hablando de mis compañeros de trabajo y yo, ¿quiénes somos?
You.
I. Nosotros. We.
Nosotros. We.
Entonces con we, ¿cuál se pone? Am, are o is?
Are.
Ok, that's it.
Ya me enredé.
So, my co-workers and I are taking a meditation class right now. Right?
Uh-huh.
Aquí, ¿por qué no está bien que le pongan I am? Porque no solamente está hablando de yo, estoy hablando de mis compañeros de trabajo y yo. Y como somos muchos, no va a ser am, va a ser are. ¿Ok? Va, sigamos. Vamos a ver, ahorita para arriba, de ahí para arriba, ¿tienen alguna pregunta?
No, teacher.
¿Estamos bien? Va, vayan fijándose en the time expressions, ¿ok? Time expressions.
Uh-huh. Estaba confundida, pero con esto que no acaba de corregir, sí, ya entendí bien.
Ya, va, ok. Si tienen preguntas, háganlas. Dice, right now. So, ahí hay un punto, ¿ya se fijaron? Quiere decir que ya terminó esa oración. So, dice, it's great. Meditation. Meditation es el sujeto. Es como que hablen de it. Meditation, really, you. La meditación realmente te relaja. Ahí, si se fijan, están hablando de meditation. So, la meditación es como que fuera it. ¿Y qué pasa con el verbo cuando va con she, he, it?
Meditation really is relax you.
¿Por qué is, Margarita? Si les acabo de decir que nunca, nunca, nunca me mezcle el is, el are y el am con otro verbo.
Entonces sería do you relax.
¿Por qué do you si no es pregunta?
Sí, sí.
¿Qué le ponemos a lo...? Hay alguien de aquí de la clase que me preguntó a mí, teacher, ¿y si hablo de ella y de él? Le tengo
oh,
que
se agregar. Le agrega la S.
Ah, va. Pero como se termina en X, acuérdense de esa regla.
Uy.
SH, relax. CH, va, relaxes. Va. Miren, ahí está. Todas esas reglas tienen que venir a su mente ahorita. She, he, it, la S. Pero si termina en CH, en X, en Y, le quito esa letra y le pongo S. Pero nunca, por favor, ya no me hagan esos errorazos. Is, go, is, play, is, drink. No, no, no. ¿Ok? Vamos, terminamos esa. Vamos a una nueva. Do you like to play sports? Not really. But my wife and I. Ahora bien, le pusieron are enjoying, ¿sí? Yes. Díganme en esa oración, ¿dónde está la expresión de tiempo? Right now, this month, this day. ¿Está? Para que le hayan puesto presente continuo. Está ahí la...
¿For swimming?
No, swimming no es right now, this no.
Es de baseball.
Ajá, no hay. Entonces, all base right. Form. Base form.
Ok.
Pero, ¿cuándo es base form? ¿Qué le vas a quitar? Pero mi esposa y yo disfrutamos nadar. ¿Ves? My wife and I enjoy swimming. ¿Por qué no va el ing ahí con el verbo to be, el presente continuo? Porque no hay una expresión de tiempo que me diga que va a ir esa. ¿Sí? Esa oración se parece, viene todavía de la pregunta que te hicieron arriba. Si la pregunta es con simple present, La respuesta es simple present. Porque si se fijan ahí, no hay un punto ni nada, sino que cuando dice not really, coma, quiere decir que la oración sigue. Same idea. ¿Ok? Va, sí. Vamos a la otra. We usually go to the pool together in the summer. ¿Ok? Very good. Ahí está. ¿Cuál es la expresión de tiempo ahí?
Usually.
¿Va? ¿Ok? Va. Ahora termina la oración. Miren, hay un punto. Summer. Y empieza otra oración. Miren. Now that is winter. ¿Qué van a poner? Cuéntenme. ¿Cuál es la expresión de tiempo?
Now.
Ajá, now. ¿Y esa expresión de tiempo es para simple present o present continuous?
Present continuous.
Ok, entonces ahí me van a usar present continuous. Y como dice not swim, ¿cuál sería?
Swim. I don't swim. I not swim. I don't swim.
No, no me mezcle el don't. No me mezcle el don't con el ing. Eso es lo peor que pueden hacer.
No, o sea, I no swimming. I am swimming.
Ajá, vale. I am y el negativo.
I am not swimming.
Excellent. Ajá, very good. ¿Cuál es la clave aquí, Margarita y Ivane? Time expressions. Tienen que aprenderse cuáles son las time expressions. Ponele I'm not, porfa. I'm not. Ajá. Ponele ahí tienen que tener en su mente. What are the time expressions for the simple present? What are the time expressions for the present continuous? Y obviamente saber qué es el simple present y cuál es el present continuous, right? Para negar en presente continuo es el verbo to be. Yes, I am, no, I am not, you are not. No tienen por qué poner don't, ¿ok?
Sí.
That's it, but si se fijan después de eso, I am not swimming at all, hay un punto. Quiere decir que la oración ahora la que viene es nueva. Búsquenme ahí la time expression, por favor. But every my day. Wife, every day, every even day. When it's cold. What is the time expression?
Every day.
Every day.
Every day. Y con every day, ¿qué van a usar? ¿Present continuous o simple present?
Simple present.
Simple present. Y si está hablando de mi esposa, my wife.
Goes.
My wife.
My wife. Dice, but my wife.
Goes every day. That's it. Very good. Bye. Hagan la número tres. Pay attention to the simple, to the time expressions. Okay.
Yes.
Hello, hello, hello.
Hello.
Okay, guys. Arrégleme aquí, please. Vamos, do you have your, tienen ahí sus respuestas. Ok. ¿Qué tema estamos viendo ahorita? Cuéntenme.
Un repaso del simple present.
Ajá, ¿y del?
Presente continuo.
Presente continuo. Entonces, ¿qué está haciendo en la conversación número uno un verbo en pasado? Worked. Va, ese es mi primer regaño. Cuidado con eso. No me mezclen pasado aquí si estamos viendo temas de simple present. Vamos a ver. Gabriel, you read the number one, please, letter A, and Gabby, letter B.
Ok. Yo no voy a regresar.
Comparto la pantalla.
No, no problem. Yo lo tengo aquí. I have it here. Ajá. Gaby, Gabriel, you are... Hey, Gaby, Gabri. Gabriel sí. Gabriela. Number one, Gabriel, letter A, and Gaby, letter B.
Okay.
How do you cope with stress? Do you get stressed a lot?
A lot?
A lot.
Well, generally, I don't feel stressed, but we are working long hours this month.
Ah, miren el time expression. This month. Entonces, we are working. No tienen que ponerle pasado. Ok, va, vamos a ver. So,
my coworkers and I are taking a meditation class right now. It's great. Meditation really relaxes you.
Very good. Okay. Porque meditation is it. Okay. Mm-hmm. Very good. Number two. Continue, please, Gabriel.
Do you like to play sports?
Not really, but my wife and I enjoy swimming. We usually go to the pool together in the summer. Now that it's winter, I don't go swim at all, but my wife goes every day, even when it's cold.
Okay, va, en la antepenúltima. Now that is winter, ¿cuál es el time expression en now that is winter? Mm-hmm. What is the time expression? Now that is winter. El time expression ahí es now. ¿Ya ven? Tienen que copiar las time expressions en sus cuadernos, right? ¿Cuáles son las time expressions de simple present? ¿Cuáles son las time expressions de present continuous? El now es una time expression para present continuous. Y si now es una expresión para present continuous, ¿qué está haciendo ahí? Don't swim. Right? Ahora, vamos a arreglar esa. Please. Okay. Now, that is winter. ¿Cuál es el negativo de not swimming? I'm not swimming. Ajá. Okay. Pues sí. But my wife goes, ahí está bien porque dice every day, a time expression de the simple present. Va. Okay. Vamos, number three, okay. Go ahead, Gabriel, number three.
Does your family do anything new to stay healthy?
Mm-hmm.
Actually, yeah, we try to eat a balanced diet. I mean, mm-hmm. everybody in the family loves fast mm-hmm. food, but right now we are cooking healthy meals.
Good.
It's not easy because my husband doesn't like vegetables and things like that.
Okay, very good. Ahí sí estamos bien. Okay, that's it. También puede ser en la de arriba, do your family, okay? Do your family.
Ajá,
that's okay.
En la
treja,
digamos.
Yes, en la treja. Do your family do anything new? Ahora.
Pero se puede.
Yeah, that's okay. Ajá, that's okay. Mm-hmm. Puedes decir family have o family has. No problem.
Okay.
Okay. There is no problem. Okay. So, ¿qué importa aquí? Time expression, guys. Time expressions. Si ustedes no identifican las time expressions, van a poner lo primero que se les ven en la mente. Y ahí es donde hacemos la mezcolanza, ¿ok? Cuidado, okay. Poner verbos en past tense, because we are not studying past tense. Ok, very good, very good.
Y dice, y si lo pongo en español, quiero ver.
Ajá.
Ajá, teacher.
Ajá, ¿qué van a poner en español?
No, aquí lo estamos tratando de averiguar. Es que estamos confusos, teacher.
¿Verdad?
Yes.
Va. Nos quedamos en enjoy swimming.
Yes.
Va, que no. Uh-huh.
Los de arriba están bien.
Vamos a ver el de arriba. My friends and I are working a meditation class right now, right? That's okay. Cuando dice la otra, no. Meditation, really?
Relax.
Otra vez, ve. Indian. Meditación, realmente, relajándote. No me usen verbos chulones con ing. Miren, en la otra, en la número dos, en el we usually going. ¿Por qué? ¿Por qué? Ya lo regañé, ya les dije. Entiendan eso. El verbo con ing nunca va a ir solito. Nunca. Tiene que llevar a la par el verbo to be. Pero como ahí dice, we usually... El usually no es para present continuous. El usually es para simple present. Entonces, ¿cómo va a ir el verbo?
We usually go.
Go, exactly. ¿Va? A veces... Los alumnos tienen miedo de que, y solo go, o sea que no cambia nada. Pero ¿cómo es posible que solo vaya go? No, algo le tenemos que poner, no creo que sea tan fácil. No, ya ven, ustedes le ponen cosas de más. No, si así es de fácil esto. Simple present, verbo pelado, sin nada. Excepto que esté hablando de una mujer, de un hombre o el it. Como el caso de arriba en la unidad, en la 1 en meditation. Mírenla. La meditación es como que usted hable de un pronombre it, ¿verdad? Entonces, como ahí no lleva now, in this time, right now, vea que no.
No.
Entonces no le pongan eso. Va a ir el verbo normal.
Ok.
Pero como está hablando de un it... Dice la regla que cuando hablen de she, he, it, al verbo se le agrega S. ¿Se acuerdan? Vuelvenos, Fátima. Víctor no estaba aquí. Pero cuando el verbo termine en X, CH, SH, ¿se acuerdan? Eso se le agrega S. Entonces ahí, ¿cómo me quedaría? Meditation, really?
Relaxes.
Relaxes you. That's it.
Mm-hmm. Okay, teacher, in the in this case, but my wife sería...
Busquen el time expression. ¿Cuál es el time expression? En esa oración.
Every day.
Vaya. ¿Y con every day qué va? ¿Simple present o present continuous?
Simple present.
Va. Entonces, ¿cómo va a ir el verbo?
Go.
Go. Pero estás hablando de mi esposa, una mujer. She. ¿Cómo va a ir el verbo?
She goes.
Goes. Va. Esas reglas tienen que volver a su mente ahorita. Arreglemos la de arriba, por favor, la que dice I don't swim. ¿Ok?
I don't.
Va. También arregleme esa de we usually, ¿vean? We usually go to the pool together in the summer. Miren, ahí se fijan, hay un punto, quiere decir que la otra oración es nueva. Ahora dice, now that is winter, ¿cuál es la expresión de tiempo ahí? Now.
Okay.
Uh-huh. What is the time expression in now? Now that is winter.
Now is... Present continuous.
Present continuous.
Va. ¿Y por qué le han puesto don't swim? Ah.
Mm. Uh-huh. Entonces, okay. Now, no, now that is winter, I swimming.
Pero es negativo. Mira. ¿Cuál es el presente continuo en negativo? Es el primer verbo que nos aprendimos, Fátima. El verbo to be.
I'm not.
Bye. I'm not. ¿Qué?
Swim.
Swimming.
Swimming.
I'm not swimming.
That's it. Uh-huh. I'm not swimming. ¿Cuándo voy a usar el don't? Cuando es simple present, pero no se mezcla el don't con el ing. ¿Ok? Ajá, I'm not swimming. Ahí le pone W, I, N, G. Ajá, that's it.
Con doble M, no solo una.
Con
double M. Ok, va, nos vamos a quedar ahí, ok, porque todavía ahí vamos a ver los demás. Ok, there we go. Ok, guys, thank you, ok, we're coming back. Thank you very much for. Aquí tengo sus respuestas, okay.
Teacher, le mandamos lo que hicimos ahorita también.
Yeah, please, okay.
Es que no, que las manda. Lo que pasa es que vos sos.
Teacher.
Okay, ahí.
Gabriel, no te rías, hombre.
Yeah, the picture, you can send me a picture. Okay, no problem, no problem, no problem. Okay,
that's it.
Póngale ahí, okay, va. Acabo de descubrir que tenemos graves problemas, pero así graves problemas del presente simple, present continuous, okay. Vamos a hacer algo, okay, porque no puedo dejar este tema así. Ok, vamos, Daniel, ponga atención porque usted es uno de los primeros, ok. Este tema, si usted no lo capta, va a ser bien difícil después que pueda expresar ideas en inglés. Y me interesa mucho, pero como dice el dicho, ayúdate que te ayudaré, ok. Algo que sí quiero que quede bien claro, chicos, es que si ustedes no toman fotos o no copian en sus cuadernos, pues estamos mal. No lo sé, no hablo por todos, pero sí sé que algunos no lo hacen porque a la hora de preguntarles se quedan a... En cambio a otros, cuando les pregunto, hacen esto. ¿Ves? Ah, sí, y ahí yo noto que sí lo hacen. Va. Necesito que hagan esto que quede bien clarito, ¿ok? Vamos a ver estos dos temas simultáneamente, pero necesito urgentemente que usted sepa cuál es la estructura de Simple Present, cuál es la estructura de Present Progressive, ¿ok? Y cuando ya la tengamos en la mente, ¿qué es? ¿Para qué se usa? ¿Y cuáles son las time expressions de cada uno? ¿Ok? So, vamos a hacer algo. Tomorrow, we have normal class, ok. Mañana les toca a ustedes hablar de su, de sus likes and dislikes, right? Using the expressions. Y el lunes, vamos a ver este tema, ok. Yo les voy a mandar al grupo de WhatsApp el listado de las time expressions for simple present and the time expression for simple past. Por present continuous. Quiero que haga algo, que se las memorice, que las identifique. Al menos que cuando yo le pregunte el lunes, time expression for simple present, ah, esta. Time expression for present continuous, ah, es esta. ¿Ok? Y el lunes voy a volver a repasar, bueno, no a repasar, voy a volver a explicar el tema de simple present. Aquello que vimos cuando se le agrega S al verbo, ES al verbo, cómo se niega, porque ahorita me están haciendo la mezcolanza del año. Me están poniendo verbos con ING. Do you taking? y eso es lo que no tienen que hacer, ¿ok? Así que ahorita estoy viendo, no le voy a corregir a nadie el ejercicio, porque obviamente sé que hay muchos problemas en eso, ¿ok? Aún los mejores de la clase han tenido problemas en eso. Entonces, pero ahí vamos otra vez. Como les digo, este módulo es un repaso, pero si no agarraron en aquel mes, en aquellos meses, lo básico, aquí va a ser un solo despelote. Y aquí es cuando dice el alumno, no entiendo, qué difícil, me voy. ¿Ok? Esto es el meollo de aprender este idioma, porque hay que dominar esas reglas. ¿Son difíciles? Fíjense que no. Hay muchas personas que lo logran entender, pero necesito de su ayuda también. Que repasen esas time expressions. Yo les voy a mandar unos videitos, voy a tratar de videitos cortos, pero no para que ustedes lo, o sea, véanlos, entiéndanlos, pero el lunes yo ya voy a repasar, pero les voy a hacer preguntas el lunes para ver si ustedes me han respondido, si han estudiado eso, ¿ok? Porque la idea ya no es comenzar de cero, sino que al menos de que tengan ya un conocimiento. Por ejemplo, Jesse, ¿cómo voy a negar yo en presente simple?
Ahí nomás utilizando el auxiliar do y das, pero el negativo sería don't y doesn't.
Ah, muy bien. Ese tipo de preguntas le voy a hacer. Vanessa, si yo hablo de una mujer, de un hombre o un animal, ¿qué le agrego al verbo en presente simple?
Letter S, when depends the verb.
Ah, depends, so the letter S. Yes. Okay, that's it. En su mayoría, letter S. Ah, muy bien. Dinora, ¿se mezcla el verbo to be con otro verbo?
No, nunca.
¿Nunca? Y para hacer preguntas, ¿qué auxiliar uso en presente simple, Dinorita?
El do o el does.
Va, esas preguntas le voy a hacer basado en unos videitos que le voy a mandar, ¿ok? Ustedes son bien platicones, quiere decir de que tienen la habilidad de que no son tímidos. Y estas reglas las tenemos que arreglar, ¿ok? Pero como les digo, ayúdate que te ayudaré, porque pues son 30 o 20 y tantos, entonces yo no puedo estar con todos al mismo tiempo, lastimosamente, pero sí he visto que hay bastantes errorcitos de esa forma, ¿ok? Algo grande que le voy a pedir también es, hagan la unidad 1 y la 2, la 3 no la comiencen todavía, porque es esta, y no vaya a ser que vayan a tener muchos problemas y les vaya a salir malo todo, ¿ok? So, tomorrow, guys, get ready for your likes, dislikes, ¿ok? Con la expresión I can stand, I absolutely love, I really like, etc. I am into, I am keen on, ¿ok? Using those expressions to express likes and dislikes. Vamos con la foto de attendance, ¿ok? The pictures with the attendance. Irving, Gabriel, Erika, okay, Roberto, very well. Activating your cameras. And there we go. Okay. Roberto, are you there? Yes, okay, very good. So, 1, 2, 3. Excellent, guys. Okay, vamos a ver cuántas pantallas tenemos aquí. Okay, para no quitarles más el tiempo, aquí tengo ya la asistencia con sus nombres en la foto. Yo ahí la pongo después, okay. Vamos a mañana vamos a empezar. ¿Quién pasa mañana? Pues it's a surprise, ¿ok? So it's a surprise, you don't know who's the first one that's, ¿ok? Lo vamos a hacer aquí en una que tengo aquí para escoger al azar, ¿ok? Random.
No estoy de acuerdo, okay.
So Jesse, you are the first one, thank you. Ah. Ok, let's practice, ¿ok? No se me achicopalen, no se me achicopalen que no está perdido, pero sí hay que ponerle más atención a este tema, ¿ok? See you tomorrow, guys. Have a beautiful morning. Okay. See you tomorrow, Friday. Take care, guys.
Bye.
See you.
Bye.